pas, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans la ami canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yokus. I hope you're doing fine today. This is the second video of the week. I hope you guys are exciting. Thank you again for watching my video. And this was gonna be another type of styling video here. It's all about building my spring wardrobe. A bit about the process when it comes to building capsule wardrobe, 12 pieces, because if you watch my video about the capsule wardrobe, I'm gonna put the link somewhere here down to just select the pieces that you're gonna be able to use again and again and keep them versatile that way. I'm gonna have two modules. Each module that I have here is gonna have 6 pieces, total of 12 pieces. We're gonna show you one by one before getting to the lookbook part of it. Come up with 25 to 30 outfits. I work full time on top of doing other things like my work, and so it's gonna be pieces that I can use to go to work. But don't have to dress up really corporate. It's really gonna be the reason why you're gonna have a couple of outfits where it's like really casual or laid back. It's because of that. Just stay tuned for that. It's gonna be exciting. It's gonna be nice. The first one that I have is this nice blouse that I bought from H&M last year. Key point or my reference when it comes to my first module. When it comes to adding patterns to your capsule wardrobe, you really need to be careful about what you're gonna do. Start with choosing the palette or the printed piece so that you can construct everything around it, and it's gonna be much easier for you to just go with a color story that just makes sense for you and for your style, of course. Here again, it's a good balance between being chic, between casual. We have the second one here, which is the top. A little bit of details. It's a neutral, so it's really cute, really nice, really basic. It'll be a really great piece to have with everything that I'm gonna have around it on top of the blouse. You can't go wrong with the denim top. Shirt, you can't go wrong with anything denim, anything light blue shade when it comes to spring in general. So much, but so much. I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do it when it comes to my own spring capsule wardrobe here. Keep versatile as much as you can and as much as you want. When it comes to this nice trench coat, I can't tell you enough of it. You adored it, and this is gonna be my outerwear. I think for spring, again, this is a really nice color for me, really nice color as far as anything else. Really good balance with any other piece that I choose to go with it. Love trench pieces in general because they're gonna bring some kind of style. They're gonna bring something really cute, really nice, and really chic. I've got 3 bottoms for this module. Can't go wrong with denim jeans either. No matter what the size is, it's really up to you to find your cut for it. If you want me to do a video on how to be able to find the best cut for you, I'm gonna be sure to do one. I think I've wore it so many times already that I can't say more than that. Boyfriend jeans, can wear them every day if I want to, so that really makes it easy for me to be able to wear it. Yeah. Bottom is really, really, really cutie. My white jeans from Zara that I simply got. My last haul, so definitely check it out. This is gonna be a one that's gonna be on my first model because one is, again, really bright for spring, amazing for spring. Last pair of pieces as far as the first module goes, it's this really cute skirt, a bit mini, but I can still wear it for work. I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna be able to style all of it together. I'll get in a Asian store somewhere downtown, and I can't remember the name, but try to find similar pieces, and if I do, they're gonna be down below as usual. Cute. I just love it. When it comes to my second module now, I have a couple of other pieces. They're really cute. Really, Letizia? I think they're really cute. Really think they're cute? Or you think they're cute? Okay. When it comes to the, you know, this blazer. Recently got it from Zara. The print's amazing. The color is so refreshing. Not too pale and it's not too dark either. So I think it's a really nice balance. Flatter your skin tone as much as possible. And that I got as an outerwear. I really went with some color shaded palette, if I could say it like that. My second module, a little bit more cooler as far as the shade go. It's my first module, so this is gonna be interesting. You know, this t-shirt from my last haul that I can wear to work as well. So mind the chic, the casual, the street size from time to time, as long as it's just appropriate. Thankful for it, to be honest. Any option. And I feel like t-shirt could be really dressy depending how you're gonna style it. I love the patterns, just so cute, and I love the colors as well. Other one was this nice little crop sweater, but you can wear something underneath it so that nobody can see anything. They don't need to. And because it's still a little bit cooler, we have some days where it's like really nice, and yesterday was honestly the best day ever. We have our days where it's like really cooler, so we still need to wear something warmer. My white top, this one is so cute, really dressy, really feminine, really elegant. Can lift the tie here, the office, and anybody working in a kind of more office dressy, you definitely can go with that. First bottom is gonna be this one, and I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna style it. It's a white one, it's a cooler palette. I think here is my denim skirt. It's denim distressed jean skirt from Zara. I got it last year. Not something that everybody is gonna be able to wear to go to the office, but keep in mind, like I told you, that I can do that, but not every day. This is something that I definitely can do for the Fridays. That's only what I'm gonna do for the holidays. If it doesn't resonate with you and work with your office wear, wherever you work, the other outfits you can get inspiration from. Last bottom is this nice silky pink skirt from Zara. You guys loved it, adored it. That couldn't be missed, that I just couldn't not add it in my capsule wardrobe. It pink, really cute. There is no pattern. The pattern itself is so popping to the eyes because of the fabric. Doing anything around it, it's just gonna make it better, better and better. So as far as the bags go, 2 bags per module. Bigger bags as well. I went with the mini one because it could be really cute, but at the same time it could be really easy for you depending if you don't carry a lot of stuff. Stripe bag that you guys know already a lot all the time, because it's a kind of neutral bag for me because it's black and white. It to pair it with anything really. Second one is from Zara as well, and it's the snake printed type of bag here. I love the stud. I think just gives an edgy side, and you know my edgy side, I can't not live without my edgy side, so that had to be added here. Another one that I recently got from Zara for my last haul for anything after work as well. So love the details, love the shell details here. Golden tri type of bag. Last one from Topshop, my acrylic bag. As far as the accessories, most of the time I keep almost the same. They're really good at going with most of my outfits in general because of the color story that I have. The shoes is probably gonna be the same thing. really boring when it comes to shoes, except for my white boots. You know my white boots, they're so easy. White boots are the things here. Now let's get to the lookbook. Now let's get to it and let's play magic here now.
Something better came along.